My name is Neil Garcia Latt. I'm 21 years old, and I have a question I'd like to direct to the whole panel, but it was spurred by what A.W. Singham brought up. In light of your call for young people to pursue alternative careers, could you express your ideas on how we as young people are to pursue lives which are truly ecologically sound and environmentally renewable, as well as ones in which we can monitor and confront those who are working to advance the needs of our national security state? In short, how are we to reconcile our desires to become, say, subsistence farmers with our duty to hold accountable those who are advancing the advent of our increasingly more pervasive police state?
That's a pretty daunting question for the end of is it a question or a statement?
It's a question. It's a realistic question.
Okay. No, it's very hard to answer the question again. I'm sorry. It's very hard to answer the question without becoming flippant, because it's such a serious statement. It requires a thoughtful response, and I hate the thought of, you know, being flippant. So, but I could only say very quickly, my problem and advice to young people is I've got to keep them in school. That's my big problem in Brooklyn. The dropout rate amongst black students is horrendous. To keep citizenship alone through the educational system is a massive endeavor. So now I would say, beginning in terms of young people, not that the school is the only answer, but the whole notion of making the university and the educational system an arena for the creation of citizenship is one of the first tasks. The second is, once you do that, their entry into the market system, wherever they fit into, will be determined by their, what I call, transformation of their consciousness. So with working people, it is not easy to just say transformation of consciousness. They tell you to go to hell. They say, get me a job. So ultimately, we return to the market situation. So there is a dialectical tension between youth being thrown into an educational system, thrown out of it through no fault of their own, and then when they come out of it, attracted to the becoming members of the violent system. Now, if we can then, and this is not a plea in my case, the whole theory of the necessity of the introduction of a peace curriculum right from the primary school.
I was just afraid that that question would take an hour or two to answer, but Professor Singham sent it very quickly.